Hello, my dear baby, and everyone else. Welcome back. After a nice cup of Earl Grey tea, I am back, and I already feel much better. That expression, that's the expression of someone who died 6 times in a row. That's the number of fingers on a mutant hand. But soon, you will need to find a mutant hand with even more fingers. Oh wow, that was a big mess up. Great starting, eh? Here we go. Well, I don't care. Yeah, I need to gently tap it, but not too gently to jump up. Oh. Yeah. All of these needs to be thoroughly practiced. Okay, about time to heal. These are just all just practice sounds. I'm having a great time. You are incorrect, sense, when you said prepare for a bad time. I am having great time. Oh, that was not that bad. Then I continue messing up. Wow. Wow! Yeah, how about time for another healing round? Yeah. So yeah, good news is that I don't need to defeat you, friends. I can just have fun with you, torturing you, fighting you. And then when I got bored of you, if I cannot get through, I can just leave you here behind to the dust. Standing here forever. Fuck! 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 You felt your sins weighing on your neck. Yeah, I cannot move left or right when I am in that mode, otherwise the entire sequence will be fucked up. F you, sense. Yeah, how about I heal up for maximum, since in the second part, the little legendary hero, for some reason I want to say little hero, the legendary hero will be very limited use, so the snowman piece would be very limited use too, since the attacks are so difficult to judge and dodge and everything, there is a good chance that you will just lose back any of the 40 hit points you get back. So yeah. So yeah, let's concentrate now. Yeah, I cannot defeat Sensei, but still, you know, just try. Okay, 5 each point. And that day is today. Ah! Okay, I got a new dialogue. And that day is today, but unfortunately because of the karma counting down, I will not have that much time to read what he's wanting to say, especially in the menu he's attacking me too. So yeah, this is, you know, a taste of what is coming. I will just continue fighting and the first part of the battle will be just completely mundane and boring. But I will still suck at the second part. That's the expression of someone who died 7 times in a row. Hey, that's good. 7 supposed to be a lucky number. Who knows, maybe he will hit the jackpot. Nope. And that number will multiply tenfold. Yeah, that's more than likely. Oh fuck, I forgot where I am. For some fucking stupid reason, forgive my language, I moved left. I should just move down and right. And I messed up that timing already. So yeah. In fact, you're seen crawling on your back. All of this scene narration by Chora are determined on how much parameter damage I have right now. Oh fuck. Oh fuck! I'm completely messing up everything. Fuck you, Sans. Yeah, so you see this, all of these early parts will be as mundane and boring as this one, after some practice. Even this one is a little bit tricky, but yeah, it's just stay down. Yeah, that's it. And these bones too, after some time I will figure out when to move, how to move. Yeah. Another round of the bones. No, because there's some randomness. Here too, I basically just have to concentrate on... Okay, so 16 HP is pretty low, but let's see the state. So yeah, right now I'm just practicing.
Fuck, multiple fucks.
Let's try this legendary hero. Okay, so yeah, it was just one attack away from it. That's okay. Okay. Heal up to maximum. Okay. Oh no! When it's blue, I have to wait. No! Fucking hell! When it's blue, I have to wait for it first. Oh, 6 HP. Okay, bye, Sans. One HP, and yeah. So yeah, that's it. I already said this multiple times, I will just repeat myself. As Sans put it, it's a bad time. Because yeah, the first part, which is for a first time player, will be, you know, miserable just as much as the second part is for now. You know, it just... Yeah, spiders, yeah, I don't care about how I look. I duck. It's the easiest attack and I messed it up too. Unexcusable, oh fuck. I don't want to fight you anymore, Sans. Yes, I sure can defeat you, but why? Oh, why I need to, you know, spend my weekend fighting you for hours on end? I don't need to prove anything. Especially since once I already defeated you. So why, brother? Fuck me and my life. No, don't. After you only level at him. Six HP, who cares? This fucking bone puzzle cares. 1 HP. Legendary hero. Oh fuck! Thank you. So a pain stick will only heal me to 84, so I eat two legendary heroes instead. Let's do this thing then, see? Fuck you! I need to heal. Noodles. I messed up one time and then that messed up the entire thing. Fuck. Sense is starting to look really tired, and yeah, the last thing he said is because all of this fighting tires me out. So yeah. And yeah, you see. At least the menu bones can't hear me, but all of the times I want the item and the bone goes through it, it hits me. Wow, yeah, thank you, Sam. And if you keep pushing me, then I'd be forced to use my special attack. What? I think I accidentally spared Sans. So yeah. That was the that was Undertale. Yeah, I believe. I believe, yeah, I might will return here later. And yeah, try more, but yeah, it's really pointless. So I will just read up what Sans is telling. Since Laura, you did told me that you won't watch someone else finish the genocide, well then I will just read this up, and after I read this up I will be, you know, relieved of not having to try to defeat Sans. Okay. So where is the dialogue? Oh, by the way, the refights. Yeah, the refights. Yeah, the refight 7 that I just skipped. That's the expectation of someone who dies 7 times a row. Oh, no, 8. That expression, that's the expression of someone who died 8 times in a row. That's the number of fingers on a spider, but soon... Wait, don't spiders have legs? Anyway, there's a special couple more of these, so I will just show you off those. But yeah, I am having no willpower or determination left to keep fighting. That expression of someone who died... What? 7 times a row? Oh yeah, I remember this, yeah. That's the expression of someone who died 7 times in a row. Nope, wait, that's definitely 9, sorry. Or was it 10? Yeah, the easiest attack and I must attack consistently. Because it's too easy. I didn't even pay attention there. I took the auto ended. I was phased out. Healing time. Let's heal up with a legendary hero. The legendary hero here. I could heal with a stick, that would leave me. But yeah, as you see, I don't have really time to heal with the legendary heroes. Yeah, let's just heal with the legendary heroes since the world in the second part is really limited. Approaching zero. Because of the fucking bones, I was trying to hastily go to fight, instead I ate the instant noodles, so, yeah. Fuck you, fancy. Fuck you! You fucking bastard! Reading this doesn't seem like your best use of your time, yes, because your fucking stones are attacking me. No, I melted him! Yeah, so fuck it. Fuck this entire thing. I am sick of it. So I try to move quickly between the menu, and of course that leads to being incorrect. Sans is starting to look really tired. It doesn't matter, I'm out of healing items and yeah. And if you keep pushing me, yeah. My special attack sounds familiar, well, get ready, because after the next move I'm going to use it. So if you don't wanna see it, now would be a good time to die. Yeah. And I don't have any more, yeah, fuck you, anyway. I'm not going to get to this, yeah. Yep, almost. So yeah, it doesn't matter. But I am getting really close, so with a little bit more, luck and concentration, I could defeat Sensi, but yeah, I mean, why should I really? Especially since I will. I would reset just right afterwards, so yeah. Oh yeah, I missed reading that up, I'm sorry, 10. That the expression of someone who died 10 times in a row. Hey, congrats, the big 1-0. Let's invite all your friends over for a big shindig. We can have pie and hot dogs and... wait, sometimes not right. You don't have any friends. Yeah? Okay. Yeah, just a little bit more input than what needed, and I'm hitting the wand, so it's not hard, but oh. This attack order is just too. I am going to heal. Yeah, I need to practice moving quickly between the menus. You see, that's what I was talking about. Even after 10 games, these parts are just... Fuck it! That one is not yet perfect, but I am getting about it too. This one is crazy. So I basically have to use this bridge moving thingy as a platform moving left and right. Okay, I think healing would be right, yes? It's really, really stupid, difficult. Oh fuck! Mm-hmm.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
If I was clever about it, I would have eaten the stick instead. It doesn't matter. It will not depend on this. Fuck it. Fuck it. Fuck you, son. You can damage me all I already want. I need to heal here. And then remember to move left 2 times and hit the enter. Not earlier than 2 times left. Okay, that was good. Fuck it! There's no reaction time to react. There's nothing. I am not a teenager to react to this. I don't have the reaction time. And yeah, so that there is the end. Yes, if I practice a lot of time, spend hours here, I will eventually defeat Sans, but yeah, I have no intention. So yeah, now comes 11, that expression, that's the expression of someone who died 11 times in a row. Well, give or take, there is nuance to this stuff. Don't think I will be able to count very well from here. Count for me, okay? We will start from 12. And we fight 12 and beyond, let's just get to the point. Yeah. And we fight after killing Sans. So if you kill Sans but don't save, exit and load back, he will say, that expression that you are wearing, well, I won't grace it with a discussion. And we fight after killing Sans two or more times, that expression that you are wearing, you really kind of a freak, huh? Okay, and then the attacks, so... So yeah, then, okay, I will read the dialogues from where I got to. So yeah, maybe all they needed, I don't know, was some good food, bad luck, some nice friends, but that's ridiculous, right? Yeah, you are the type of person who won't ever be happy. You keep consuming timelines over and over until, well, hey, take it from me, kid, someday you gotta learn when to quit. And that's today. Because you see, all this fight is really tiring me out. This is attack 20, so 20 turn, and then attack 21. And if you keep pushing me, then I will be forced to use my special attack, attack 22. Yeah, my special attack sounds familiar. Well, get ready, because after the next move, I'm going to use it. If you don't want to see it, now would be a good time to die. And then attack 23. Well, here goes nothing. Are you ready? Survive this, and I will show you my special attack. So yeah, attack 23 is a very it's very crazy to dodge attack, a series of rapid attacks, which are survivable. However, at the end of the attack, so you can you know dodge the first and middle part of the attack, but at the ending of the attack is a bunch of ghastbusters almost completely surrounding you and firing in a circum motion around you, and you basically have to move around the laser beams avoiding it. I cannot really just describe it very well, so yeah, it is extremely difficult to successfully do it, but yes, you can do it. And after you manage to dodge that, whew, poof, alright, that's it. It's time for my special attack. Are you ready? Here goes nothing. Yep, that's right. It's literally nothing, and it's not going to be anything either. You get it? I know I can't beat you. One of your turns, you're just gonna kill me. So, I decided it's not gonna be your turn, ever. I'm just gonna keep having my turn until you give up. Even if it means we have to stand here until the end of time, capiche? And after some time, you will get bored here. If you haven't gotten bored already, I mean, and then you will finally quit. And so when this is happening, we are in the dodge box with the heart, and Sans is just standing there, tiring. And you cannot do anything. And after some... Well, you can do one thing, but first I will read all of the things he will say. And after some more time, I know your type, you are very determined, aren't you? You will never give up, even if there is absolutely no benefit to persevering whatsoever. If I can make that clear, no matter what, you will just keep going. Not out of any desire for good or evil, but just because you think you can, and because you can, you have to. And more time later, but now you reach the end. There is nothing left for you now. So, in my personal opinion, the most determined thing you can do here is to completely give up and do literally anything else. And so what happens if you wait long enough? The Sans will fall asleep. And you can move the box, the dodge box, with your heart. You can you are still in the battle menu with the four options in the bottom, and then you are in the box and the heart is there, but you can move the heart, and you can move the heart to the left and then to the bottom over the fight button. And what you can do is you click on the fight button. A strike is delivered towards Sans, but Sans wakes up and dodges that and says, "Hey, did you really think you would be able to?" And bam, there's a second attack that slices through Sans. And the second attack is made automatically. It's not the player who is pressing that. And the interesting stat here, that whatever, you know, the kills could be different, because not the excess number of monsters killed. There can be a double attack when there is only double monsters, when there is only a single counter, so it doesn't matter. But you see, in my example, I have kills 107, and after Sans Butler, it stays 107. Because the one theory says that this is actually counting, you know, the kills I have did. Fizz did, and the fun theory says that when you strike a Sans rapidly the second time, it's actually Chara who is taking control of your body and delivers the quick strike to Sans. That Sans doesn't have time to dodge, because he can only dodge one attack at a time, and so Chara using the body to strike out, Sans cannot dodge that. And so yeah, there's a strike across Sans, and he starts bleeding from his chest and from his mouth, and there's a bunch of theories here of why he's bleeding if he's a skeleton. One is that it's liquid determination that he had been injected with determination, and the red soul have the determination power. So maybe it's a red liquid. Maybe it's the substance that was sucked out of the six human souls when Office made the experiment. So maybe it's liquid determination, and that would explain why Sense is having so much determination, remember so much things. Another equally popular fun theory is that he have ketchup under his hoodie. However, the problem is that would not really tell why does he have blood coming from his mouth too. So yeah, that would not exactly tell that one. Another fan theory is that he is Ness from Earthbound, and yes, when he was in the end game he had to lose his body, had to be transformed, his mind had to be put into a robotic body or so, some sort of that thing. Maybe he still have some internal organs or something, even though he's a skeleton. And so, yeah, senselessness is the popular fan theory that I don't believe. So that happens, and then Sense says, "So, guess that's it, huh? Just don't say I didn't warn you, Rep. I'm going to grill bees. Papyrus, do you want anything?" Yeah, and so Sense stands up while he's saying that, and slowly moves to the left, and then exits out of the screen. There is a dust sound when you defeat a monster, and then you come out of the battle there, and you will be on level 20. But the kills didn't increase, so that's there suggesting that that was actually Chiara who delivered the final attack. Oh yeah, and Hiva, the flavor test determined on how much karmic damage you are having currently. So from 0 to 10, you felt your sins crawling on your back. From 10 to 20, you felt your sins weighing. What is the pronunciation? Weighing. Screw it, weighing on your neck. And 20 to 30, karma cursing through your veins. And 30 to 40, doomed to death of karma. Yeah, and then in the second phase, reading this doesn't seem like the best use of your time. And yes, Sense is starting to look really tired. Sense is preparing something. Sense is getting ready to use his special attack. Oh, and the fascinating thing here, if the game is closed during the battle, Sense calls this as death when making his next comment before battling the protagonist again. Okay, and so what happens after the Sense fight? probably I should look up the exact dialogue and not just go by head. You meet with Asgore and he's trying to talk to you, but you jump basically immediately into battle mode and he say no need to be hasty or something like that. Dialogue. Aha, okay, I'm getting there, okay, I see. Okay, and in the room with the coffins, the red coffin says, it's as comfortable as it looks. So yeah, Chara is saying, when checking the coffin, it's as comfortable as it looks. Okay, within the throne room, Asgore mentions having never seen a Plavir crying, referring to Plavir's attempts to warn Asgore of the protagonist. The protagonist then proceeds to attack Asgore, killing him in one hit. Plavir finishes Asgore off, and then, with his face and voice turning to Asriel's, he begs the protagonist not to kill him. This is the final point where the game can be reset without consequences, as pressing any of the action buttons causes the protagonist to kill Flavie. Aha, I wasn't exactly sure if this is the last point, but according to this, yes. So yeah. Yes, and I remember this, so yeah, the Flavie's remember this from seeing it in other Let's Plays. That because I never got to this part. After I defeated Sans one times, I just resetted. So yeah. Sans, Flavir face is turning to look like Ezreal's, and Ezreal's soundbite is saying, "Please don't kill me." And yes, I remember, so the text doesn't continue and it's, you know, waiting for player reaction. And so if you press, you know, any of the action buttons as it said, then it's kills Flavie. So that's the final point I see. He begs the protagonist not to kill him. This is the final point where the game can be reset without consequences, as pressing any of the action buttons causes the protagonist to kill Flavie. Pretty gruesomely too, the animation is pretty gruesome. Basically, continues to attack Flavie until there is nothing left of him. Each attack is just demolishes the Flavie's body more and more, until the final attack literally erases all traits of Flavie. And then, instead of leaving the black screen and returning to the throne room, a track consisting of high-pitched wailing and echoing heartbeats begins to play as Chara appears on the black screen and talks to someone, either the protagonist or the player directly. The window name becomes blank with no border, so if you play a windowed mode. Chara explains, I want the actual dialogue. Okay, that should not be hard to find. Oh. Come on. This is all nice and dandy, but I want the actual dialogue, Internet. Why cannot you give me that? Want the dialogue. Why don't you give it to me, interwebs? Can't believe. Aha, okay, aha, I found it, good. So, greetings. And greetings is the same as, same thing as Toriel, yeah. Toriel says greetings and Chava says greeting, and Howdy is Asgore, Asriel, and Flavi. Namibaka! I'm sorry. I have been disturbed. So yeah, where I was. Okay, yeah, so the Ventura appears. Greetings! Oh, why did I I'm so... Concentrate. You know, exclude the world around you, because you are recording for Dialora, okay? So concentrate. So, Chora appears. Greetings, I am Chora. Thank you. Your power awakened me from death. My human soul, my determination, they were not mine, but yours. At first, I was so confused. Our plan had failed, hadn't it? Why was I brought back to life? You. With your guidance, I realized the purpose of my reincarnation. Power. Together, we eradicated the enemy and became strong. HP, attack, defense, gold, EXP, love. Every time a number increases, that feeling. That's me, Chora. Now we have reached the absolute. There is nothing left for us here. Let us erase this pointless world and move on to the next. And you have two options, erase or do not. Erase. Right. You are a great partner. We will be together forever, won't we? And then Atax comes from Chara, and the entire screen is filled with nines, like, you know, when there is a damage above someone's head, and the entire screen is filled with nines, and even if you are in full screen, the game turns into minimize mode. And the window of the minimized, not minimized, but what it's called, I was just talking about that, not full screen, which means window, yeah, windowed mode, yeah. So even if you are in full screen mode, when that happens, it turns into window mode, the nines fill the screen, and the window is jumping left and right. around, and then the game of course closes. If you select do not, as you know, let's erase this pointless word, do not, no, how curious, you must have misunderstood. Since when were you the one in control? And then there's a jam screen. Jealous eyes bulge out and starts laughing with very good x-ray, and also it starts to grow. And then the same happens. There's attack coming from Chiara. Nice, fill the window. It turns into window mode and jumps around, and the game closes. So it doesn't matter what do you choose. And then when you open up the menu or open up the game, there's a complete blackness in the game. There is only sometimes a little wind. I remember. There's a wind noise in the background. And that's it, it's complete pitch black, nothing happens. And if you wait 10 minutes in the blackness, then text will appear, you know, presumably from Chora. Interesting. You want to go back. You want to go back to the world you destroyed. It was you who pushed everything to its edge. It was you who led the world to its destruction, but you cannot accept it. You think you are above consequences. You can say exactly. You think you are above consequences and you have yes or no option. If you say yes, then Chora says exactly, and if I remember correctly, yeah, if you say yes, Chora says exactly, and if I remember, so if you say yes, he says exactly, and you have to wait 10 more minutes before you have the option to choose again. If you say no, you are not above consequences, then Chora says, then what are you looking for? And after 6 seconds, perhaps, we can reach a compromise. You still have something I want, give it to me, and I will bring this world back. If you say no, then stay here for all eternity, and you have to wait 10 more minutes. If you say yes, then it is agreed, you will give me your soul. And if you say, So, Chora says, and I will bring the world back. If you say no, then stay here for all eternity, and you have to wait 10 more minutes. If you say yes, then it's agreed. You will give me your soul. And you can say yes or no again. If you say no, then stay here for all eternity, so wait 10 more minutes. And if you say to the you will give me your soul yes again, then it's done. And I think the game closes, and when you open it again, it will be back to normal. However, you know, the intro will play, and finishing the genocide counts as a true reset. However, it's not actually a true reset. You can play the game normally, like as if it was a true reset, but if you play a true pacifist, then the tail end of the game, the ending will be changed. If you stay, you have places to go when Toriel asks on the surface where you want to go, what you want to do. If you say I have places to go, then you will have a picture of all of your monster friends with you in the middle. Well, in post-genocide, the picture will appear, but instead of Frisk, Chavavi is standing there smiling, and all of the monsters will be crossed out with the red. You know, implying that they all died in the genocide run, making you remember what you did. And if you say you want to stay with Toria, you will have the cutscene where you are in the bed, Toria brings you butterscotch pie, axes, but then Frisk gets up from the bed, and then Chora face appears, and one of her eyes glow red, and there's a laughter. So yeah, both is making you remember what you have done, because that's Chora is about, that no one is above consequences, and killing the entire underground is not right. And you see, in the genocide ending, it doesn't matter that Orpheus have ever created all the monsters that she could. It doesn't matter if the monster kid managed to run away and then and meet with Orpheus, and Orpheus might have saved them. It doesn't matter, because of the end of the genocide run, Chora destroys the universe, the world, the entire game, it gets destructed. And so it doesn't matter if Ralph is saved. The only timeline where it matters that Ralph is saved is the special neutral ending that I showed. Then, yes, Ralph did a great thing. Well, no, Ralph did a great thing anyhow, but it doesn't mean anything in the genocide ending. So yeah, and if you do a second genocide route, and you go to a point where you kill Flavi, Chora will appear and says, "Greetings, I am Chora, Chora, the demon that comes when people call its name. It doesn't matter when, it doesn't matter where, time after time I will appear, and with your help, we will eradicate the enemy and become strong. But you and I are not the same, are we? This soul resonates with a strange feeling. There is a reason you continue to recreate this world. There is a reason you continue to destroy it. You are rocked with a perverted sentimentality. I cannot understand these feelings anymore. Despite this, I feel obligated to suggest, should you choose to recreate the world once more, another path would be better suited. Now, partner, let us send this world back into the abyss. Erase, if you choose erase, like, you are a great partner, we'll be together forever, won't we? So that the same, and if you say, do not, no? This feeling you have, this is what I spoke of. Unfortunately, regarding this, you made your choice long ago. And so yeah, that's about Chora. And of course, the Chora haters has been long been trying to twist what she's saying here, especially if you do genocide the second time, that Chora is saying that they are the demon that comes when people call its name. And they are just loving to twist that out of the context. So, no, Chora is, and also another thing that people, Chora haters, like to say that Chora is possessing poor Frisk, and Chora is controlling, and Chora is behind everything. That's all bullcrap. They are all trying to relegate their responsibility of doing this to someone else, something else. So no, Chora isn't an evil person. Yes, Chora did wanted to kill 6 more humans when they were on the surface with Ezreal. However, be mindful that Chora committed suicide to let that happen. So it's not like he exactly put others above himself or herself, because well, they did pay the ultimate price that they can pay for that. And then they died again together with Ezreal. And then we woke them up. We and Flavi together woke them up. And, you know, they woke up confused. And what they ended up being with is this Spice-up cat. Psycho cat. Yeah, I think I am pronouncing that right. Psycho cat. Anyway, so yeah, they ended up being tied to this asshole who just killed everyone. And yes, we can, you know, have different point of views. We can say that the actions were justified this way too. But yeah, what we ended up teaching Chara is that might makes right, power is everything, and yeah, at the end, this is all that matters. I will just fight Sans one more time, just for the fun of it, and I will not reset right now, I think. That expression that the actor of someone died 11 times in a row, well, give or take. That is not actually stuff. Don't think I will be able to count from count very well from here. So yeah, we are at 11. Count for me, okay? We will start from 12. Here we go. Yeah. So yeah, technically speaking, I could just, you know, come back and fight them anytime I feel like. But yeah, why would I do that? But yeah, no point in doing a reset. Now I can just, you know, come back and try. Ah, that was great. Yeah. But yeah, no point really. Especially since you know now how close I am to actually the point of no return where I will return from. So yeah, you see, there's, you know, no trouble getting here, and with practice, I literally, you know, could do this blindfolded. So yeah, And there are people, of course, quite some people who practice so much that they can defeat Sen without getting hit a single time. I am not one of those people. I will eat the steak here and fight Sen for last time probably. But I am really cool too. Fuck! No, I met with him! Yeah, so that's what I am talking about. No, 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 no! Yeah, you see, I mean, this is fucking ridiculous. Who the hell wants to waste his time doing this? Yeah, fuck you, Sans, I hate you. And then the fucking menu attacks you even, I mean, no time of that, this is almost undoable, but then the menu doesn't leave you any time. So yeah, I had enough. Thank you, Sans, for your services. Fuck you. Burn in hell, you. So yeah, that was Undertale Genocide. I hope you had fun. I didn't have a bad time, actually. I was enjoying myself to some degree. So hopefully, probably this will be the last episode. Bye bye.